Hello there, my name is Dominic and what I have here today is a 22 kHz switch. It looks a lot more like a splitter, but it's not. We're going to learn the difference in this video. Its work is to switch between two satellite dishes into one receiver. The receiver can be a satellite decoder or a satellite TV. In this video, we're going to learn how it works, how to install it, all the settings on your TV or decoder, the difference with a splitter, the advantages, disadvantages, and finally, something to do with DiSEqC switches. Let's start with the biggest advantage, and that is it enables you to connect two satellite dishes to one receiver. In order to use the 22 kHz switch, you need two signals from two separate satellite dishes, and they both must be working. If I connect this to the TV or decoder, it should be working, and if I connect this to the TV or decoder, it should be working. And these two inputs should be installed in the LNBA and LNBB ports. To connect it to the TV or decoder, you require a separate piece of coaxial cable. I will start by connecting it to the TV. For best practice, always install your switch outside, and that's primarily to save on cable length. Don't use such a short cable like I've used here. Always install it outside so that you can have short cables to your satellite dishes and a longer cable to your decoder or your TV. It's also always a good practice to write down your installation as you go along. For example, for mine, I know LNBA is connected to my satellite dish directed at 7 degrees west. It's the Nilesat group of satellites. And my LNBB is connected to 68.5 degrees east, which is Intelsat 20. And this is how the 22 kHz switch works. It primarily relies on the TV or the decoder. What happens is the TV or decoder will send a signal or not send a signal. 0 for not sending a signal and 22 kHz signal. When this switch sees nothing, it will pick a signal from this LNBA. If it sees a signal, a 22 kHz signal, then it's going to switch over to this other satellite dish. So it's going to pick from LNBB. It's that simple. So what's the difference with a normal splitter? Well, a normal splitter, its work is to take a single antenna input and split it between two televisions. As I've already explained, you see a 22 kHz switch is much complicated than that. So don't confuse the two. They are very different. To visually see these two signals in work, I have my satellite finder here, and it's going to light up either 0 or 22 kHz. Now what I've done is I've disconnected the 22 kHz switch from the TV, and in line I have connected the satellite finder. Although I am using my LG TV, you just need to know the basics so that you can change the settings on your decoder. This is the normal situation, one satellite dish connected to one TV. But with the 22 kHz switch, we need to change some settings. You see this one, LNB frequency 9750/10750. With this selected, sometimes it's known as universal. With that selected, the 22 kHz tone is in the off position. So we need to change this so that this one can stop being grayed out so that it can work. When I select 9750, you can see that the 22 kHz tone has been enabled. And I'm just going to set that to A. Now you can see we have two satellite dishes and the 22 kHz switch. My satellite one here, which is Intelsat 20 out there, has been set to 22 kHz tone A. And my satellite two here, which is Nilesat at 7 degrees west, is B. And that's all you need to do. After this, we just do a satellite search. If it's your first time setting up the 22 kHz switch, please leave the DiSEqC part in the off position. I'm now conducting a satellite search, and you can see that my satellite finder is showing the 22 kHz tone is selected, and that is for Intelsat 20. In a few minutes, this green light will change to 0 Hz when it's searching for Eutelsat 7W. I hope you saw that it has changed to 0 Hz, and that means that it's picking a signal from LNBA. LNBA is 0 Hz and LNBB is 22 kHz. On my satellite finder, you can see that it's displaying 22 kilohertz. That means that it's picking a signal from LNBB. I will now change the channel to a channel on Nilesat so that you can see that light change to 0 hertz. I believe that is on Nilesat. You saw that light change. And now this is 0 hertz. This means that the TV is sending a signal to pick a TV channel from LNBA, which is at 0 hertz. That is the power of a 22 kilohertz switch. The advantage, you can connect two satellite dishes to a single TV. The disadvantage is that you can only switch between two satellite dishes. So how do we solve that problem? Well, you can use this, and these are usually much more readily available in the shops. This is known as a DiSEqC switch, a digital satellite equipment control switch. With this gadget, you can have one receiver, TV or decoder switching between four satellite dishes. And not only this, you can even get one with 8 inputs. And it's exactly the same process on my satellite TV decoder. This is the TechnoSat T888 satellite decoder. And that is, you have to change the LNB frequency from universal so that the 22K here is not grayed out and works. At the moment, you can't select it. But if I change the LNB frequency, yes, 9750. And if I come down, you can see the 22K is now enabled. That selection is now enabled, and I can set it to on. As you can see, you just have to know the basics so that you can use the 22 kilohertz switch. I can certainly say that I have taken care of my curiosity with the 22 kilohertz switch, which is not readily available in local markets. And that's why, like I pointed out before, it's better to just use a DiSEqC switch. Now, when it comes to DiSEqC, there are quite a number of versions and compatibility. With the DiSEqC 1.0, you can switch up to a maximum of 4 satellite dishes. And this protocol is usually available on older decoders and televisions. But what if you have more satellite dishes? Well, this is where my curiosity is picking again, because with the 22 kilohertz switch, you can actually use it and two DiSEqC switches to switch up to 8 sources with an older decoder or satellite TV. Now, I really want to try this out. Although I don't have a lot of satellite dishes like I used to before, I really want to try this out and see if it works. For example, in this image from this forum from the way back in 2007, you can see that for satellites 1 to 4, you select 22 kilohertz on, and this is that. And for the rest, from sats 5 to 6, select 22 kilohertz off. And with this simple system, you can use an older decoder or satellite TV and switch up to 8 different satellite dishes. This is very interesting. This system can even work with 5 satellites. Look at that. Using one 22 kilohertz switch and one DiSEqC switch, you can have 4 satellites on the DiSEqC switch connected to one port on the 22 kilohertz switch, and the extra satellite dish connected directly to the 22 kilohertz switch. Again, very interesting methods. This is very creative, I might say. So would you like to see me try any of these two methods? Please tell me in the comments below. I hope you learned something new today. If so, please leave a like, subscribe if you haven't, and please share this video with your friends. Let's meet in the next video, and goodbye.